In our today's session, we'll discuss the concepts of straight line motion along with some problems. I hope it is audible to you. Lahari.
Yes, sir.
Shall we start? Okay. So first of all, motion along a straight line. I hope already you are aware of few definitions, basic definitions, sir. First one is about you people need to know about the basic definitions, say distance and displacement, next average velocity definition, and average speed. These are the few requirements for this topic: average velocity, average speed. Next, average acceleration. I hope these basic definitions are clear to you. I hope so. Distance traveled by the body, it is the distance traveled is nothing but the path length. So path length is nothing but the distance traveled, and second one, shortest path between any two points. Shortest path between any two points is nothing but it gives you the displacement. And third one, average velocity. Defining average velocity is easy. If you know what is the distance and displacement, you can easily define average velocity and average speed. So average velocity is the total distance, total displacement by total time taken by the particle or body. Total displacement by total time taken. This is average velocity. Next, average speed. Average speed is total distance by total distance by total time taken. This is a displacement vector, displacement by time. This is average velocity. And this is a distance by time, scalar quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity which has only magnitude and direction. Charita. Charita, are you a student? So, is this clear, Lahari?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Are you sure? Rakshita, Rakshita, so these are the basic preliminaries or basic definitions which you need to know regarding the straight line motion. If you already are aware of this, that's fine, and we can proceed with the further concepts of straight line motion. But if you don't have the basic idea, you have to listen. That is, these are the few definitions we have. What are they? Distance, displacement, average velocity, average speed of a particle, average acceleration of a particle. A body or a particle, when it is moving in a straight line motion, in different ways, in different types of motion. How to calculate the distance, displacement, average velocity, average speed, average acceleration. These are the things. First one is distance traveled. Distance traveled means the length measured along the path of a body. We call it as path length is distance. So to explain this, I'll take one example. Suppose this is the path of a body. So the particle is moving in a straight line, but by changing the directions, A to B once, next it turns towards north, B to C, then it turns towards east, C to D, like that, it's maintaining different, it's moving in different directions along a straight line, A to B, B to C, C to D, individually along straight lines. Then the length from A to B and from B to C and from C to D. So these lengths, if you measure, if you add, as per the definition, the length measured along the path of a body is distance. Length measured along the path of a body means, as you measure the length along the path of a body, path of the particle is given. This is the path of the particle. Along the path, if you measure the length, that is distance. So here, as per the definition, distance is 3 plus 4 plus 4. So it is 10 meters. And displacement is obtained by joining a straight line from initial path to final path. This C to D, this length A to D, this length gives you the displacement. So the definition of displacement is the second one. Displacement is a shortest path between any two points is displacement. Shortest path means the line joining the initial point and final point with a straight line. If you join initial point and final point with a straight line, this length of the straight line gives you magnitude of displacement. Means what? To find the numerical value of displacement, you should join initial point, final point with a straight line, and the length of the straight line gives you the displacement value, numerical value. So why, you may ask, why should we join the two points, initial point and final point? Why should we join? We have to join because it is the shortest path. The between any two points in a plane, the shortest possible path is obtained by joining the straight line only. So if you take a curved path between initial point, final point, it can't give you shortest path. Only straight line length can only give you the shortest path. So displacement, how to find means, I'm calculating it like this. AD length, A to D length, this is straight line length, if you calculate, that will give you the displacement. Imaginarily, I'm calculating C. This is a 3 from A to B. It is 3 meters. And from here to here, this remaining length, it is again 3 meters. So this is 3. This CD is 3. So this is also 3. So this is 3 meters from here to here. And this is 4. So this opposite length, this is also 4 meters. So displacement S magnitude is between A to D. It is a root of, under root of right angle triangle. This is 6 and 4. 36 plus 16. So you'll get the answer. Displacement you can find out. These are the basic preliminaries, the basic fundamentals. Charita, what about you? Charita, you can unmute and you can ask. Whether it is clear or not, you can tell. Rakshita. Is this discussion clear to you, Lahari?
Yes,
Any
sir.
Doubts from your side? Okay. Okay, ma'am. Rakshita, what about you, ma'am? Charita? So, next step. So, this displacement you can calculate here. The next discussion is about average velocity. It is total displacement by total time taken. So, we discussed how to calculate the total displacement. The total displacement by total time taken, we can find out. So, next, the next discussion is about average speed. Average speed is total distance by total time taken. The total distance traveled by total time taken. Yeah, we'll continue further. Next, now we are discussing. After this basic aspects, we shall discuss about here the average acceleration. Let us discuss about the average acceleration. So average acceleration is a change in velocity vector divided by time taken, or you can write it as, you can mention it as v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1, or you can even write it as a v minus u by t, the change in velocity vector by time taken, means a final velocity minus initial velocity by the time interval, or instantaneous velocity second instant minus first instant by difference of the times taken, t2 minus t1, or you can write final velocity minus initial velocity by time interval time taken t. This is a average acceleration, and it's a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and direction, and acceleration obey the parallelogram law of vectors. It's a vector quantity. And average speed, this is a scalar. Next, this is a distance, this is a scalar. Next, displacement, this is a vector quantity. Average acceleration is a vector quantity. And we have one more definition for a displacement. So displacement is also defined as the change in position. Change in position, that means final position minus initial position. Change in position means final position minus initial position. So these are the different basic definitions required for straight line motion. Is it clear? Any clarifications from my side which I have to give? Shall we proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now here we are discussing the concepts of uniform, the concepts of straight line motion. Here the concept is uniform acceleration. This is the concept. Uniform acceleration means definitely particle is moving in a straight line. I am not deviating from that. The particle is moving in a straight line. But the particle is undergoing this type of motion, which is called as uniform acceleration or uniformly accelerated motion. Uniformly accelerated motion. That means we can even call it as when the particle moves with constant acceleration. So acceleration remains constant. Acceleration is constant. So this is one type of motion. Means particle moving in a straight line. Definitely it is moving in a straight line. In a straight line motion, particle can undergo uniform acceleration. Means it can move with a type of motion. It can move in terms of a type of motion called as uniform acceleration. And we define it like this. In uniform acceleration, the acceleration is said to be constant. Acceleration of the particle is said to be constant when both magnitude and direction of acceleration remain constant. Means what? If the body is accelerated in such a way that the acceleration magnitude and the acceleration direction both are constant. Means I'll show you how the uniform how the acceleration is. This is a particle, suppose, and we are providing a velocity, initial velocity. Means I am just giving some velocity to the body. I am just giving some velocity in this way, and this is the acceleration provided or acceleration acting on the body. The acceleration A bar acts on the body. And when this acceleration A bar acts on the object, it affects the body in such a way that its speed will increase. Its velocity is going to increase. That means, suppose initially you have thrown it with V velocity. It is, or you have pushed or you have given an initial velocity V bar. And if somebody are accelerating from outside, if somebody are accelerating the body, the velocity will increase. It will become 2V after some time, or 3V, 4V, 3V by 2, 5V by 2, etc., etc. So the velocity keeps on increasing with the time. Why velocity should increase with time? Because of the acceleration acting on the body. The object is accelerated, and the object by itself, it can't accelerate. This particle by itself, it can't change its velocity, it can't increase its velocity. Somebody, myself, me or you, or somebody has to accelerate it by providing the acceleration. Let me take one example for this. What example means, sir? This is one example. Uniform acceleration, one example I'll take. The freely falling body as an example. Freely falling body means what? I am ignoring air resistance. I am considering only the gravity to be acting and I am ignoring the air resistance. Air resistance means what? When object tries to move down, air opposes, it tries to oppose the motion. I am assuming that the region or the place or the room where the particle is dropped, there air resistance I am neglecting, I am considering it to be, it's the effect of air resistance is negligible. So now let us see the same thing happens or not. Suppose I have a particle, I have a body, I'm just dropping it down, and of course I'm not providing any initial velocity, but gravity is acting, acceleration due to gravity acts in the downward direction, g acts in the downward direction. So what I can say here, acceleration due to gravity g, this is initial velocity zero. After some time on the object, some it gains some velocity, it picks up some velocity, and gravity acts in the downward direction always, sir. So that means here the velocity and acceleration due to gravity both are in the same direction, so its velocity increases. So initially I dropped it with a zero velocity. After some time it may pick up, it may attain a velocity say 10 meter per second or 20, 30, so on, etc. So if I am just dropping this particle, then acceleration due to gravity acts on it, and the gravity, acceleration due to gravity acts in the direction of motion. In the direction of motion, acceleration acts. I am not providing, frankly, I just dropped a particle now, I just dropped a small pen cap right now, but I didn't provide any acceleration. I just released it. I have just released it, that's all. So gravity acts on the body. It accelerates the body. And air resistance is neglected here. And this is one example of freely falling body. And one more example is also there. This is for negative acceleration. And now this is the way how we can represent the acceleration. If this A bar, if it is constant, then it is said to be, this acceleration is said to be uniform acceleration. And particle's velocity keeps on increasing. It won't decrease. Its speed means magnitude increases, and direction is not going to change. So along the same direction, it is going to move. I'm assuming that there is no other acceleration, only this A acceleration is active. Next. So there will be one-dimensional motion if initial velocity and acceleration are parallel or anti-parallel to each other. Means parallel means this. If initial velocity V and A bar, they are parallel to each other. Parallel means they act in the same direction. And suppose if initial velocity this way and the acceleration is acting in this way, both in the opposite direction, then that is anti-parallel. The acceleration acting on the body is anti-parallel to the initial velocity. In that case, what happens? Body's velocity tries to decrease. Body's velocity tended to decrease, and finally it may stop. That also I'll show you. This is the particle. Given initial velocity towards right side, towards positive direction. And acceleration acts like this. This is the negative acceleration. Suppose the direction of motion is positive, V bar, it is positive, then this is negative. So here this is plus and plus. So this is negative acceleration, which this A bar, it is going to decrease the velocity of the body. So its velocity reduces fine after some time, and as the velocity reduces after some time, it may come to rest. Its velocity doesn't reduce, it continuously keeps on moving with increasing velocity until some obstacle is there. And now for such kind of motion, how to solve problems basing upon such kind of motion? And this first one is this one is a uniform acceleration, and the second one, this is said to be uniform deceleration or retarded motion. This is a decelerated motion or retarded motion, where A bar is constant. The A bar magnitude wise, it is not changing. Same numerical value is said to be having for this A bar. And this is also A bar, I am assuming it as constant. It is uniform acceleration, it's not increasing. A bar is constant. So these are the expressions we make use for solving such kind of problems of straight line motion. Don't be under a misconception. These equations are not just for straight line motion. These equations applicable for accelerated motion, uniformly accelerated motion. Uniformly accelerated motion means acceleration acts on a body in such a way that acceleration is constant by magnitude and by direction, and it supports the motion, it increases the velocity of the body. And suppose I have started I just want to travel from one place to other place. I just start the bike, and now immediately, if I just start the bike, it's not sufficient. I have to move from one place to other place. And for that purpose, what I do is, initially my speed is zero when I start the bike. Now I slowly raise the accelerator. I just raise the accelerator. Then what happens? That accelerator is said to be providing the acceleration to the bike. So what? Its speed increases from 0 kmph to 10 km per hour, 20, 30, 40, like that. I keep on accelerating, raising the vehicle. So it provides the acceleration. So in that way, the bike's acceleration continuously, it keeps on increasing. And assume that I have on the road, on a no traffic road, I'm traveling on a straight road, and assuming that there is no traffic, but I have reached to a 50 km per hour, and I just saw one obstacle. So I just pressed my brakes slowly. I have applied brakes gradually. Then from 50 kmph, gradually the speed reduces to zero. Slowly stopped. So from 50 km per hour to zero. So that's how braking or applying brakes will give you the retardation or deceleration. That is said to be the retardation. And in that case, retardation or deceleration or applying brakes, acceleration, the retardation is provided by the source opposite to the velocity, opposite to the direction of velocity. And these are the equations applicable for either uniform acceleration or uniform deceleration. For deceleration, you just replace with minus A. Plus A you should write with minus A, and here plus A you have to replace it with minus A. That's all. So this equation I can replace as V square minus U square equal to minus 2AS. This is for retarded motion. This equation S is equal to UT minus half AT square. Just a small change for negative acceleration for retarded or decelerated motion. This is for accelerated motion and decelerated motion. Accelerated motion, decelerated motion. And this one, V equals to U minus AT. This is for plus A, accelerated motion. And this is for decelerated or retarded motion. These equations are applicable for these type of motion. And examples of uniform acceleration are freely falling body and body projected vertically upwards. If a body is projected vertically upwards, I am projecting with some initial velocity. It reaches to some height and it stops over there. For a while, it stops at that place. And for a fraction of a second, it stops there and it comes back. So this is the case of a decelerated motion. Why? Because the reason is velocity is up, gravity acts in the downward direction. We are trying to move the body up, and acceleration due to gravity is acting in the down. It is opposite. G is nothing but the acceleration provided by gravity, which is in the downward direction. Lahari, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So freely falling body is an example of uniform acceleration. Body projected vertical upwards is an example of uniform deceleration or retardation, assuming that there is no air resistance. And this is one equation which is helpful for distance traveled during nth second. U is the initial velocity, A acceleration, n means the particular, that particular second, third second or fourth second, at whatever instant you need to find the displacement, that second you have to substitute in place of n. For during third second means between 3 to 4. If you want to calculate the displacement, you find out by substituting n equal to 3, like that. And this is the next type of motion. We have seen first type of motion we have seen just now is uniform acceleration. That's what we have discussed just now. And the second type of motion also, whatever we discussed just now, it is uniform deceleration or uniformly decelerated motion. This is an minus A deceleration and here it is plus A. This is how we indicate the acceleration and retardation. And the third type of motion is 1 and 2. For this equations we know V equal to U plus AT or V bar equal to U bar plus A bar T, and S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And if you replace that minus A, you will get retarded motion. But now this is the third type, uniform velocity. Uniform velocity, that is when particle moves with zero acceleration, means uniform velocity means velocity of the particle is constant. Velocity is constant, and that implies acceleration is zero. Particle's acceleration is zero. In a simplest way, in a very easiest and simplest way, I can say what is uniform velocity. In that bike example which we have taken, as I just started the bike from 0 kmph and I slowly raise the accelerator, and I'm just traveling on a straight road, I have reached to a maximum speed of say some 50 kmph, for example. And as it was a no traffic road, I continuously I'm maintaining 50 kmph throughout the for some time, for a few minutes, for 1 minute or 2 minutes continuously. For those 2 minutes means 120 seconds, continuously I was maintaining for same speed, say 50 kmph, I maintained, assume. So then that 2 minutes for which you maintained a same speed in the same direction, that can be called as a uniform velocity. That type of motion can be a uniform velocity. And uniform velocity means the by magnitude and by direction, magnitude by direction, we are not supposed to change. Means direction I am not changing, magnitude 50 kmph I am not changing. So if I suppose, you may ask, sir, same 50 kmph I just changed the direction, means I am not moving on a straight path, then what? So with the same speed 50 kmph, if you are moving by changing the directions, it is uniform speed, not uniform velocity. But neither I change the direction nor I change the magnitude, and continuously the magnitude of velocity and direction of velocity, continuously I'm maintaining the same. So 50 kmph in straight road, in the straight path. So that can be uniform velocity. And if we consider a term called as uniform speed means only the magnitude remains same, means suppose it is body or particle is or bike, whatever it is, moving with say 50 km/h, this speed is maintained constant, but directions it changes its direction. Just assume that I am not changing the speed, slight direction changes are there. So we can't say that it is uniform velocity. It can be considered as uniform speed. Only the magnitude of the speed, that numerical value, 50 kmph, this is only constant. Just an example I am giving you. This is the example. But the uniform velocity means velocity remains constant and acceleration is zero. A particle is said to have uniform velocity if magnitude as well as direction of its velocity remain same. And this is possible only when the particles move in same straight line without reversing its direction. Without reversing its direction means if particle is moving like this and if it changes its direction, if it reverses its path, then you can't say that it is moving with uniform velocity. You can say it is moving with uniform speed. If direction changes and value, numerical value doesn't change, that comes under uniform speed. But neither direction changes nor the magnitude, numerical value changes. None of them are changing continuously or maintaining uniformly. That is uniform velocity. So, next step. So, this is about the third type of motion here. Which for such kind of problems where uniform velocity is involved, which equation you have to apply? So you have to use this equation. Velocity is a displacement by time, and displacement equals to velocity into time taken. And next, speed. If it is about speed, the distance by time taken. If it is displacement and velocity vector quantities, this is the equation we can apply. From this, you can write this. So, why? Because in a question, continuously, for some interval of time, the particle may move with constant acceleration. And after, say, some third second, the acceleration stops acting and the particle or the body may move with uniform velocity for up to, say, some 10th second. So in such examples, in such questions, what are you supposed to do in such questions? Something they'll ask, velocity at 3, find the velocity of the body at 3rd second, find the velocity at 10th second, or calculate the average velocity during this motion. Some questions are asked in a problem. Then what are we supposed to do here? How to deal with the combination of different types of motion? The first 3 seconds, I considered it as accelerated motion. The 3rd to 10th second, I'm considering it as uniform velocity. And 10th to 15th second, I may extend this, or the question may be the extension for some more time with retarded motion, minus A, and this one plus A. Then for such kind of combinations, what you are supposed to do? The problem solving strategy is how to apply the equations. What is the strategy? For first 3 seconds, use that equation only. Which equation? Either V equal to U plus AT or S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Those three equations that you can use with plus A. And if you want displacement in 3 seconds, use S is equal to UT plus half AT square. If you want the velocity at 3rd second, V is equal to U plus AT. If they give body starting from rest, you take U equal to 0. If not, if some velocity initially is given, you use that initial velocity. 5 meters per second, 2 meters per second, something. And the next interval, how to proceed? Different equation. From 3rd to 10th second, constant velocity. Velocity is displacement by time. Displacement is velocity into time. Whatever is the velocity at 3rd second, that is same throughout up to 10th second. Why velocity at 3rd and 10th second are same? In between, if you take 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, anywhere you take, the same velocity should be there. That's what is uniform velocity. Neither direction should change nor magnitude should change. That is uniform velocity. And from 10th, again retarded motion means slow down. This is a speeding up. We can call this, in a general word, we can call it as body or particle is speeding up. Here in general, here what you can say, this body or particle is said to be slowing down. It is said to be slowing down. So here the velocity reduces and finally it may come to rest somewhere, which we have to find out. So this is about if in combinations, if types of different types of motion are given for same body, means a body is moving in straight line only, but for some interval, for some duration, it is moving with constant acceleration. For the next interval, it is moving in different type of motion, uniform velocity. For the next interval, it is moving with a different kind of motion, that is retarded or decelerated motion. So this is how we use. Here we use the equation, sir. And here we use this one, displacement is velocity into time. And here again, the same three equations with a negative sign. V equal to u minus at. S is equal to ut minus half at square. That's a negative sign for retardation. And we have to solve questions related to this in that way. Any clarification from your side? Is it clear? Is it clear, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Just see this question. One second. So in this question, a body travels 30 meters in an interval of 2 seconds. Means here 2 seconds interval is taken, 0th second, and this is 2 seconds. A body travels 30 meters in a 2 seconds interval. This is a straight line motion. Next interval, the object in the next interval, it is said to be moving 50 meters in the next interval, and this next interval is also of 2 seconds. Means what? This interval is 2 seconds, means this should be 4th second, and this should be second, 0th, second, and this should be 4th second. So this interval is from 2 to 4, interval is 2 seconds. So these are the displacements in first interval and first 2 seconds interval and next 2 seconds interval, 30 and 50 meters. Find the acceleration of the particle and initial velocity. So this object's initial velocity we have to find out, and acceleration, it moves with constant acceleration. That acceleration we have to find out. So how to calculate the acceleration? First, displacement S1 is given. It is S1 equals to 30. So 30 equals to initial velocity u into t, ut plus half a into t square. Why? Because initial velocity we don't know, and the displacement is 30, and time taken is, the interval is 2 seconds interval. So here 30 equals to ut, time is 2 seconds, so 2u plus 4 by 2a, 2u plus 2a is 30, and this can be written as 15 equals to u plus a. This is the first equation, 15 equal to u plus a. 2 I am taking common, and 30, if I send this 2 to this side, 30 by 2, 15 we will get. And the next interval you can see, that is S1 plus S2, not next interval, the total entire interval, S1 plus S2 equals to u into t plus half a into t time, 4 seconds, t square. S1 plus S2 is 80, 50 plus 30, 80 equals to 4u, this is ut, plus half a into t square. So the equation which we get here is, say 80 equals to 4u plus, this is 8a. And if you simplify this, what you will get, u plus 2a, 4 if I divide on both sides, so this is u and this is 2a, 1u plus 2a equals to, here also if you divide by 4, this will be 20. So this is the second equation. If you solve these two equations, you can get u and a. So first equation is u plus a equal to 15. Second equation is u plus 2a equals to 20. So if you simplify, you can find out the acceleration and initial velocity. And how I simplify is, say, one method is substitution method. One is by solving. So substitution method, if I take first, suppose that I want the acceleration and initial velocity. Suppose if I want acceleration, I want to eliminate initial velocity. U is unknown, A is unknown. U I want to eliminate. So what I can do, from this U value, I'll take 15 minus A, substitute in second equation. So U value, how much I got from first equation? 15 minus A. So 15 minus A plus 2A equal to 20. So, and if you simplify, you will get acceleration. So 2A minus A is A. This is plus 2A and minus A, it is A. And 20 minus 15 is 5. Acceleration, we found the acceleration here. So this is 2A minus A is A. And this 15, this side, 20 minus 15, 5. So acceleration we got, that you substitute here. So A is equals to, A equal, this is 5 we got, acceleration is 5 we got. So U is equals to 15 minus 5. So initial velocity is 10 meter per second. How we are getting? Whatever acceleration we found, that you substitute in the first equation, you can find out the acceleration also. So these are the answers. And in the next session, we'll discuss some more number of questions. Is it clear? Any clarification required? Lahari? Okay. Okay. We'll continue in the next session.